Hello, my name is Nitin. Last week, we have upgraded our DASY6 specific absorption rate system
to the latest module version 6.12
ahead of the official release. We have also received a demo license for the application programming interface option, or in short, the API option. This new option permits us to further automate our SAR compliance measurement workflow. Today, in this video, I will test the cDASY6 API option. With this option, cDASY6 integrates an API server that can be used to control the measurement system remotely. The remote control commands can be executed from any computer. The great thing about cDASY6 API option is that the API server runs within the DASY6 software and enables remote control of the DASY6 via HTTP requests. It is therefore compatible with a wide variety of programming languages and scripting languages, and also independent of the operating system. The custom application software can run on any machine, but also on the same machine as DASY6. The goal of this test is to automatically execute the FCC LTE test deduction procedure from my office computer. I will use a Python script with which I automatically update an Excel spreadsheet with the SAR values being measured. To run the API server, I click the API server option from the cDASY6 toolbar, followed by the start button from the API server window. The API server is running on the DASY6 PC. So I will remotely control the measurement system from another computer outside the lab chamber. To test the connection from the remote machine, I run a simple command to read the list of available DAEs in the hardware setup window. The commands are simple HTTP GET and SET requests with parameters defining the inputs, and they return the required information.
I will now show the FCC LTE test reduction procedure as defined in KDB 941225 D05 LTE section 5.2, implemented using the cDASY6 API.
To see the effect of the commands on the DASY6 software, I will connect remotely to the DASY6 computer running the API server and show its screen alongside the script code. The script is started once and updates the measured values to the Excel spreadsheet. For this test case, I will restrict the measurements to an area scan. We have already determined that the worst case position for this device is the bottom edge, where the LTE antenna is located. The device supports bands 1, 3, and 5. The FCC LTE test reduction is based on the conducted power measurements of the device for different channel bandwidths corresponding to the 150% and 100% RB allocation at the required test channels. Conducted power measurements for this device are available in the Excel sheet and have already been read into the script data structure or database. The Excel sheet in our interface to the DASY6 system, it is updated in real time with the SAR results as soon as measurement is finished by the Python script. It also contains information on the system status, like the DAE battery level, robot server connection status, collision indication. We are now ready to measure and run the Python script. The script evaluates the SAR measurements required for the device based on the maximum conducted power results corresponding to the maximum bandwidth, i.e. 20 MHz QPSK 1 RB allocation, and measures the case with the maximum power test channel resource block offset combination. The yellow highlighted box is the current case being measured. The scan is now finished and the measured 1 gram SAR value of 0.797 watt per kg is added to the Excel sheet automatically. As this value is lower than 0.8 watt per kg, the script proceeds to measure the 50% RB test cases as required by the FCC test protocol. The measured SAR value for the 50% RB test at mid-channel is 0.58 watt per kg. As the previous results are lower than 0.8 watt per kg, the 100% RB test cases are skipped for this band and the script proceeds to measure the band 3 test cases. The maximum SAR for band 3 1 RB test case at high channel works out to 0.926 watt per kg. As this value is more than 0.8 watt per kg, the other test channels, i.e. the low and mid, are also measured for the 1 RB allocation. The script continues testing for the remaining test cases of band 3 and subsequently band 5 automatically, following the FCC test reduction scheme without user intervention. All scans are now finished. The maximum LTE SAR value for this device turns out to be 0.926 watt per kg. The API option also offers extraction of results, screenshots, and automatic generation of reports. Screenshots for any of the scans is generated by clicking the 1 gram SAR result followed by the generate screenshot button. Detailed reports in Word or HTML format for any scan from the Excel sheet is generated automatically through the script. The cDASY6 API option is an extremely powerful tool for all cDASY6 users, be it test labs, R&D setups, educational users, or regulatory institutions. It offers great flexibility to integrate accurate SAR measurements into specific user scenarios. Applications range from automated test reduction schemes to integration of automated positioners of device under test or integration of custom base station simulators. In this demo license of the API option, commands are still limited. These will be extended in the near future to allow for full control of DASY6. Thanks for watching this video.